Well, I did a quick stop in the lab here today. It's Saturday today, and we celebrated the National Record Day over at the Record Archives up in Rochester, New York. But wanted to shoot this this part here. I've got a still from the New Holland Brewery guys, just a still that they need to redo the gasket or the interface between this upper part and the lower part of the still. And the interface ring here has just got a series of holes on it, so it's got kind of a quick reverse engineering project. I've already picked up the arm and it's just a mess here in the back shop. But what I quick wanted to show you guys is when you capture data and if you need to reverse engineer it and send it back out into SOLIDWORKS or ProE or CATIA or whatever CAD package you're using, the features that I've grabbed are just planar features, and I grabbed the circles, that's the hole pattern. And there's also a notch on the other side that maybe is used for clocking this when it gets assembled, I don't know. But pretty simplistic prismatic features. So what I wanted to show you is in PolyWorks, I've got V15 up right now, and I just wanted to show you how easy it is after you've grabbed your data to export it out and then send it into a CAD package. Okay, so jump into V15 with me here. And you can see I've got all of this detail. There's a bunch of circles on there. And my notch is on this side, I think. Yeah, you can see that down here. I put a couple vectors on. There's just two vectors that that just form a little notch inside of this opening. So it made it easy for these guys to see or clock this this pattern. So I've got those in the data here. You can see that. I've also got, I've also put a line in here between a couple of those holes, and I call it my alignment line. It's just between a couple of those holes, and it goes through the center of the outside here as well. So, but that's not a feature I'd want to export out to my client. He really doesn't care how I've clocked this, or put my coordinate system on there. You can see that I've got a coordinate system right here in the side. So what I want to do though is I want to export out all of these features. You can see them all. I've got 61 holes in here, or 61 circles. Actually, there's 60 of them because my outside circle right here, that was my just the outside perimeter. So circle 2 through circle 61 are the outsides, or all the circle pattern. And the alignment line here I don't want to export, but everything else is full on. So I will highlight vector 2, left mouse key, and then I come all the way up to here. I will shift key and then left mouse button down. And I can select all of these features here in my model tree. Got everybody all selected in there. Now, the easy way to do this is just right click any place on those selected entities and run down here to export. I'll click on him, right or left mouse key. And I'm in the New Holland Brewery file here under my client's drive. And I have just got this, let's just call it the still gasket interface. And again, it's assuming that it's an IGIS file, save as type, IGIS file. That's what we like to send out. And then I just hit save. And then that file will go off and get saved into my client's drive there for New Holland Brewery. So super easy. Once you've got all those entities captured, just highlight everybody, right click, and export them out.